And we're back.
Yeah, dragon time. Sorry, we don't have more. Dragons.
Time to start up. We haven't streamed Smash in a little while. You recently just started making a lot of silver builds.
Silver, by the way, is just speed plus power.
No defense needed.
No defense needed.
And you named your Charizard Dragon Tails.
Yeah. Yep.
Or Dragon Tail. I guess wouldn't.
I was like naming my builds after like famous shows or characters that I thought fit them. Like Shulk was Top Gear, and Sonic was Top Gear USA
because he's British and American.
Yeah. And then I think I named a Zelda build Cersei. After Cersei Lannister from Game of Thrones?
Yeah, you did. That's me moving the window.
Insomniac presents...
Okay, there we go.
This guy's skipping a little bit, but that's expected.
Okay. Wasn't any drop frames during all of that, so that was just...
Here we go. I'm playing, by the way.
Yes. Don't know how long this will be. We're still aiming for one world per stream.
Yeah.
We'll see.
However long it takes.
Mario ran a little bit long.
Yeah, that happens. Okay, where were we last time? We're going to the next level.
We entered the Magic Caster's world, and we're hoping to find Puff there.
Puff the Magic?
Or Magic Crafter.
Puff. Spike, Oogene. Oh, ice level. Fuck.
Well, no, it's not ice. There's water everywhere, though.
Oh, yeah, and Spyro can't swim.
Nope. Much like another radical hero.
Well, the problem is that water physics in that game don't work properly. Like
Sonic?
Buoyancy doesn't exist in Sonic.
No. He just kind of... has lower gravity.
Yeah. Maybe he's all muscle.
So, you think Sonic is like a bio experiment, like Stitch? Because that was where he couldn't swim either. He just sank like a rock.
Oh, Stitch?
Yeah. In Lilo and Stitch.
Oh. I forgot about that. Sonic being a bio experiment?
Yeah, he's one of Cortex's lackeys.
What, like Eggman created him?
Oh, I don't know, maybe. Never really, never a lot of...
Oh, no!
Not a lot of depth to the Spyro universe lore. I mean, the Sonic universe. You don't get a lot of background.
Well, you know, some people would say there's too much lore.
This is the way you came in, by the way. You're going backwards.
Oh, okay.
You want to go right. Unless you want to catch that guy in which you just chase him around in a circle. Or maybe you just have, like, a limited time to catch him, or he jumps up there.
I guess that's the case. I'm sure there's a way up there. Damned if I can figure that out. What? Hi.
It's a bird wizard.
Oh, it's got armor?
Yes, that's what the metal is.
You can't have armor on a spellcaster? That will ruin his magic rating. You can't cast spells as well.
Is that a thing in some games?
D&D, yeah. So if a spellcaster has, like, armor and they don't have, like, whatever kind of bullshit sheets for it, to like allow that, then the spellcaster gets like massive penalties to casting spells,
because
it's like they're encumbered. It interferes with their magic capabilities.
I didn't realize you needed mobility for magic casting.
Yeah, Ganondorf seemed to have figured that shit out. Like he didn't need he's had armor and he's like casting spells.
As opposed to the physical fighting classes who don't need to move at all to do what they do.
Yeah, I'm trying to think. I think you could be like an armored magic caster in Dark Souls.
Yeah.
I think that was a thing. Because there weren't really any classes in, Guy, what are you doing?
You can't get me.
So many fucking people taunting me.
Yeah. Enemies in Spyro have bad attitudes.
Yeah, almost as bad as Spyro's. It was like, let me at him! I'll make him go splat! That's who he reminds me of! That's what his voice reminds me of fucking Scrappy Doo!
Yeah?
Let me at him! Let me at him! Puppy power!
Dragon power. Oh, you just got smacked to death. Yeah. He meteor smashed you.
Yep. Oh no.
You're not good at hitting.
With this, no. I wish Spyro had like a sword. That'd be cool, like something I could just kind of.
You could, just like line yourself up before charging and go straight and hold down the whole line.
I could do that, yeah. But people, I keep thinking they're ranged for some reason.
Oh, because they're magic? No, they just beat you with a staff.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. What the fuck?
That was weird.
I just hit start to pause it.
Hmm.
That was weird.
And they don't have range attacks. They just dodge out of your way and laugh at you. Those are some nice sounds.
Yep.
I mean, last time the big problem with the Spyro stream was that it kept dropping. That was the internet issue, but...
Or the computer issue.
Well, no, that was, I mean, the connection kept dropping. That was the internet issue. And that happened yesterday with Paper Mario as well.
Yeah, it happens. Well...
So we'll have to see in terms of choppiness if, the computer can run Spyro.
I mean, it's doing okay for now, I guess.
You don't want to go on any levels? You still exploring?
They say there's two dragons. I'm going to find those two dragons.
Okay. I hear one of them.
You hear one of them?
Yeah.
One of the dragons?
Yeah, there's like a rattling noise.
Oh, there. I didn't notice. Oh, there it is. Oh, what? Guy. What the hell? Hey, guy, help me.
Xantor!
When you see arrows like these, you can charge along with them to begin a supercharge.
Supercharge? Excellent.
Go ahead, try it.
He's not even making any one-liners is a thing. He's just kind of like...
He just got that nasally cool guy voice.
Yeah, and then...
Excellent!
And it's just like... Try more than not at all, Spyro.
Ow.
By the way, have we mentioned that's our favorite, like, evil laugh, by the way?
Not necessarily an evil laugh. It came from two sources. The first I was familiar with was Yamamoto and Bleach had that laugh.
Oh, yeah, when he was, like, taking off for sure. He's like, whoa.
And then we... Same laugh appeared in Swordsman 2, right?
Oh yeah, Master Wu, he's just like...
Master Wu had that laugh. Very similar characters in some ways, Yamamoto and Wu.
Well, yeah. I mean, I think Yamamoto would be more tolerant of transgender issues.
Maybe. Look, projectile magic. By the way, you passed a dragon.
Oh, I did?
Yeah.
For those of you who never watched Swordsman 2, first of all, do it, but second of all...
It's Wuxia Hong Kong martial arts flick.
Yeah. Where was he?
Go through into the tunnel again and to your right.
Tunnel to my right, got it. Hi, Boldar.
This portal leads to a special place where you can learn to fly. I remember when I was a young dragon, earning my wings.
Learn to fly. Got it.
Is he going through puberty? Like,
he sure sounds like it. That's another one of those flight levels, by the way, obviously.
Yeah, obvious. So we don't need to do them.
No.
Okay.
No dragons there. Is that all three of them?
Yeah, that's all three of them, so I'm gonna go back to the first level. Or this level. I don't know which one this is, but...
Hi, caves, man! Alright!
Whee! We found so much treasure.
How late did Scrappy-Doo appear in the Scooby-Doo, the original
Scooby-Doo series? Oh, that was a whole separate show. Right, keep in mind that, like...
I thought he appeared in the original towards the end of its run.
If he did, I don't know.
You have one hit left. You have no dragonfly.
Oh, shit. I need to find some succulent flesh for my dragonfly to feed. Oh, wait, there's no dragonfly.
And those tornadoes will hurt you.
Don't pay me any mind. I'm just a dragon.
Just your friendly neighborhood dragon.
Well, not friendly to you. Okay.
Ally to good. Nightmare to you.
Alright. I wonder how people first came up with the mythos of dragons. Like, giant winged creatures that are like fire breathing and out. That's not good.
Defeated by wind. Apparently, hey, that's new for you.
I was destroyed by wind. I guess I can go this way.
You could if you don't mind giant man-eating crabs, ant things, beetles.
Oh, beetle. Oh, fuck off. Oh, that'll take some doing.
Nope, too fat.
Fine. Yep.
And that's how Sparks died forever.
I am Spyro. Hear me roar and breathe fire.
What was it that at this point, like, suddenly platforming heroes all needed sidekicks? Like, that started a trend.
Sidekicks? Well, it's because it's like, well, we don't want to double down on this guy, so we'll have something for the kids.
You gotta have the main character be cool, and so for that, I guess you need the comic relief sidekick. I don't know.
You make somebody worse than him to make him seem better than he actually is.
Because Crash was always on his own. Crash was just the big dumb hero. And then you had Spyro and Sparks. You had Jack and Daxter, Ratchet and Clank. Sly had his whole team. He had his posse.
Well, yeah, okay. Ratchet was the straight man to Clank.
Yeah.
And,
actually, I just said maybe that one was the opposite. I don't know. They have a... I think they're the most interesting relationship among those.
Jack and Daxter?
No, Ratchet and Clank.
Yeah, okay.
Because neither of them are totally straight men. They kind of have their back and
forth. One is comically serious, the other is like...
Takes nothing seriously.
Yeah.
But at the same time, Clank is the one who is, like, ignorant of a lot of stuff, social cues and such.
Yeah.
Cyrus!
Please do something about these green druids. They insist on moving everything in sight.
Move it? Oh yeah, they have the ability to like alter the terrain.
Druids, huh?
The druids! There is this like Christian film, like Kirk Cameron's Saving Christmas.
Yeah.
And yep. In it, people are like thinking, we're like saying, oh, I love Christmas, I love hot chocolate. What, are they going to tell us that hot chocolate was invented by the druids? And I'm like, what fucking druids? And by the way, you're wrong, it was invented by the Aztecs.
Yeah.
Okay, how many dragons are in this level?
Three.
Okay, and I guess you got one, alright.
Yep.
Why not? So dragon's not back here.
No, this is just a side path.
Of course.
A little side place with some gems.
Fucking hell.
Yeah, you're
gonna... That is weird!
You're gonna have to glide. Moving platforms in a platformer? Outrageous!
Well, I don't... The gliding mechanics in this game are weird.
So you say.
So I feel.
That was not the right time to do that. He doesn't even have a scream. He just quietly dies.
It's okay. I'm sure I'll be saved.
It's okay. You can just glide to the bottom.
Is there a higher place I can jump from?
Nope. This is it.
Fuck. Okay. Okay. I don't know what to do.
Just wait till it's at its closest. Not when it's going away.
Good night, everyone! That was my last life. Oh yeah, I forgot the game over screen is just that.
Good on Sparks for going down with his friend. I mean, he can fly.
Well, supposedly so can Spyro, but
Only in the right level with the right magic.
Alright, hike my way back over to the... there.
Well, you can go to a level on the way there now if you wanted to.
Oh, does that exist?
Well, you're still going down this way. Still going for it?
Nah, he's gone. He's long gone.
Ow.
So he can't actually move towards me, huh?
No.
Oh, that was wrong timing.
You don't need to time it, you just need to hit them.
Hi, guys.
Also, you don't need to kill them, you're just bloodthirsty.
Yeah, I need to get out my rage on something. Okay, I guess that's the other level.
Yeah.
Alright, let's see what it is. Alpine Ridge, fair enough.
Fairly generic name.
The X of Y. Like, I like for these, like, generic-ass levels to have, like, really epic names.
Yeah.
Like, Cavern...
Oh, now that's a dragon-looking thing.
It's a wyvern.
Wyverns fly.
Well, supposedly so do dragons!
No, not necessarily. Maybe a behemoth. Although that's too mythical for these puny things.
Behemoth. Yeah, when I think of behemoth, a slightly large creature. I knew it! It's like a metal skirt.
Those look like ogres would ride into battle.
Oh, yeah.
They're ogre mounts.
You know, you think there's like an amount that like terrified the enemy, but then people realize, wait a minute, that's a stupid idea. They were able to like counter it.
It's a stupid idea to terrify the enemy?
No, it's a stupid idea. No, the enemy's like thinking, wait a minute, these fucking mounts are actually kind of stupid.
Yeah.
Like, here's an example of, like, people outsmarting,
So, like, if someone rode a titan into battle?
Oh, well, yeah.
Wait a minute, these things look stupid.
So, there was a historical, incident in which a guy had to fight war elephant dudes.
Yeah.
And they noticed that when the war elephants were getting close to camels, they just bugged out.
Yeah.
And so the guy decided to implement the first and only cavalry consisting of camels.
Spyro, you're not afraid of those big, noisy, gigantic, awful beasts, are you?
Of course not.
I didn't think so.
Thank you for that.
I take it that they were successful with their camel?
Yeah, because they didn't kill anybody, but the elephants just broke and killed themselves.
Okay.
Because camels had to use, they were pack animals. You just put shit on them.
So there are llamas in Minecraft now.
Are there?
Yeah. Also cool. As pack animals.
That's cool. Llama. People like llamas, though.
Yeah.
Llamas are like an animal that people look at and go, oh, that's adorable.
Carl fucking loved llamas.
Carl? From,
Jimmy Neutron.
Oh.
You are, in fact, going into that cave. I will tell you just so you don't try to glide somewhere and kill yourself. Gonna have to time it.
Thank you for telling me, like...
It seemed kind of obvious. You really are struggling to get a feel for this game, like how far you can glide and such.
Well, I mean, it's just so strange.
I don't know why it's strange to you.
Well, you've played this game. You grew up with this game. I grew up with Banjo-Kazooie. And Mario.
Banjo feels strange to me.
You never meant, you seem to have gotten it pretty down.
It is kind of weird that his default attack sucks.
What, Banjo's?
Yeah, like the bear claw.
They got rid of it in the second game. Now he just defaults to a roll forward.
Yeah, well that's good.
No, actually, it defaults to Kazooie just pecking for him. Just, if firing three pecks, and that it's way more useful than the bear claw. Took you out. Did I get it?
No, you didn't get it.
Oh. So weird how killing them produces butterflies.
Yeah.
I guess I'm going this way now.
Yep.
Okay, so dragon number two is over there. Dragon number three is up. How many dragons? Oh, four. So dragon number two and three are up there, and then the fourth dragon's somewhere else. Okay,
oh,
good.
Oh, lucky.
Ah! Ah! My hero!
Eldred.
Oh, thank you for releasing me.
Good talk, bro.
Thank you. Yeah, you can go away now. Of course, I would like to save.
It saves automatically.
Oh.
When you get a dragon.
Well, then why do these exist?
In case you want to come back to a save point you've already used.
Okay.
You keep trying that, expecting different results.
It's so satisfying. It's the fire is objectively the better attack.
Yeah.
You got pissed, they just decide, no, you gotta use your inefficient headbutt to take care of it.
It's only inefficient because you're bad at aiming it.
I'd rather have a shotgun. This is a shotgun. Shotguns are cool.
Shotgun without any
handy.
Impacts or anything.
Well, you
can. I like just charging through stuff without stopping, but that's just me.
Shit!
You entered the pit. You must now fight the Rancor.
That was the Rancor. There's a guy who cried for the Rancor's death in Star Wars. Like after Luke just kills that giant thing,
yeah.
The guy who I guess is his trainer just looks at it really sad, and then he goes back and he's just crying, and then this other guy's like, bro, I'm sorry, and he just comforts him.
Was that actually a scene?
That was an actual scene of that movie. Just this random ass dude crying over the Rancor's death, and then just being comforted by this other like criminal dude. Even you know what? Even fucking Jabba was pissed at that. Just like, no, the Rancor. We all liked him.
He was great to have drinks with.
Yeah. And Jabba the Hutt, upon realizing that he actually did like defeat him, basically said, "Okay, I'm gonna throw you in the Sarlacc pit. You'll be digested slowly for over 1,000 years."
But not in the good way.
Yes. Not
isn't Monster Girl Quest.
No. You're not gonna gain any pleasure from being digested. In
or
fact,
Boba Fett.
No, yeah, Boba Fett actually escaped!
Oh, yeah,
like, the dude had a fucking jetpack, and he crawled out, and he's like, okay, first off, fuck Han Solo for putting me in this position, but also, fuck the Jabba the Hutt crime family forever trying to... Xander!
Xander Cruz?
Great work, Spyro. If you keep this up, you'll learn all the tricks of the magic crafter world.
A little bit of a poor audio cutting there.
Yeah. Oh, nope, there's still one more.
There was one more that was on a ledge that you probably need to glide from here to. Look across that gap.
Oh.
Just straight turn around, 180 degrees, right there.
Oh, yeah, I see what you mean. Oh, the camera does not want to cooperate with me. Alright. I didn't get a chance to stream on my own last night, by the way.
What were you planning, Magic?
Yeah. Try it again tonight after I get my sound work done. Alright, final
probably
dragon.
Only 2 or 3 days away from episode 3 being done, by the way. We're at the very end.
These blue thieves haven't stolen eggs only in the magic crafter world. Don't worry, I'll take care of them.
Oh, well now I got it! Thank you, Spyro!
Making promises on my behalf.
Alright, fine.
This is a dangerous game you're playing.
fuck over here.
Isn't it nice to just smash through stuff without stopping, though?
Yeah. It's a shame I can't aim. Oh my god, this guy's quick! Fuck! Ah! Oh. Okay, that's my problem. Once you hold square, you're just going. You don't have to hold forward.
No.
Okay, that changes everything.
I didn't know you didn't know that.
That explains why my turning was so janky. They weren't expecting me to do that.
Yeah, it's not a run button like Mario.
Fucking hell. Or it's a... Alright. Well, that takes care of that. Good job, Spyro. Okay. So that's the end of that chapter. Let's leave the level. Somehow.
Gotta go back to the exit platform.
Well, I don't know where that is from here. I guess this is all unconnected.
Yeah, this is just a big loop.
Oh.
Over to the right.
There we go.
Then you're gonna have to glide somewhere.
Yeah, I got the egg. Because fuck it, why not?
Down there and to the left. That works
to the left?
Either way, that works too.
I didn't want to make a risky maneuver without seeing where I was going.
Yeah, I didn't think you'd make it to that one, but you whatever made it.
Let's just leave the level.
Yeah, just pop around to the right.
You can kind of jump.
Yeah, you can jump while you're charging.
Kind of. Not very well, but that they have that as an option.
You can't jump very high, but you can jump over gaps in the ground and such.
Yeah. You can't gain height really very much. Oh, you can overlook that.
That's the start of the level, so I would not glide there.
No, I wouldn't either.
Spiral levels are cyclical.
It's a big loop. Big Mobius loop. Sonic's like, why can't we live here? It's perfect.
I bet Spyro would get along with Sonic. They'd fit in the Mobius world.
I'm pretty sure Sonic would find Spyro, quite frankly, lame, because it's like, Sonic actually makes taunts, and then Spyro would just be the kind of guy who'd hang back going, yeah, what he said!
I guess. I mean, Spyro has, like, the power.
I'm saying he could hang with Sonic, no biggies. Robotnik would rather not want to tangle with this motherfucker, but...
Yeah. I mean, look at him. He's smashing metal with his horns like nothing.
Yeah. Okay, back to the high caves.
If he's using metal that's weak to hedgehog quills, can you imagine dragon?
Oh, gosh. Also, that fire breath. I can't imagine Robotnik's robots.
You can go through this cave. You just have to avoid the, you know, unkillable beetle things.
Oh, they're unkillable?
Yes.
You just can't fucking kill them? Alright.
Not with regular charges or with fire breath.
Wait, regular charges, so there's such a thing as supercharge?
Yes.
That's cool.
See, that jump was enough.
Yeah. Alright, now that I figured out the fucking controls, I was doing this wrong this entire time, and you...
That explains a lot.
Just like, you kept holding forward, don't... Yeah, okay. Oh, shit! Gotta get out of here.
Fuck this.
Hey, what's up? You are...
Ajax!
I hate those bugs. When I become big and strong, like you, I'll squash them all.
Until then, remember that supercharge makes you invincible.
How do you supercharge?
You have to have one of those arrow hills. Kind of like that one.
Did I kill it?
Yes. That's how a spark... Okay. If you have no sparks and you kill one, then sparks appears.
Alright, so there's no like... Spyro doesn't have to eat the butterfly.
No. No, that's nastier than a Nork!
A Nork. Well, that's gotta be a fusion of two words, right?
Well, it's
like orc and not
Nash, gnarly, gnarly,
gnarly orcs, norks. Those fireworks don't kill you, do they?
Yes, they hurt you.
Okay, no, thank you for letting me know.
You assumed correctly in that explosives hurt.
I don't know. It's better than, like, in some games, some explosions hurt, some don't.
I get it.
I guess there's nothing else here.
Nope.
Dang it. Why the fuck was that ledge there, then?
This is just the fireworks room.
Level design in this game is kind of weird.
Yeah?
Like, there are some like, levels in which, you totally gotta go here, and we got this important thing here. Then there are some levels that are just like, oh, we got this here for treasure, and then we got this ledge up here that seems like it could be used for something, but no.
Wait, what the fuck?
What the... Who the fuck are you people?
They threw you a freebie, and if you fall here, the fairies will save you.
Oh, okay. Well, thank you, fairies.
They realize, okay, people...
Oh! Shit. Okay, thank you, fairies.
They realize, okay, people are going to be falling a lot here. Because of the supercharge.
How many...
Indefinitely.
Okay, good.
You just can't die from falling in this particular ravine.
Oh, that's so cool!
Supercharging in this game is pretty fun.
Yeah. Yeah, better Sonic game than Sonic 06.
That's not saying much. Cedric, the Entertainer.
Try combining supercharge with jumping and gliding.
Okay.
And really explore the high game.
I'm really feeling it!
Righto, old bean! How about it?
Thank you for that cameo by Shulk. Several years before he existed.
What, just because he was British? I wonder, what's your dragon count? Oh, you got them all.
Yeah, hey, fancy that. Let's get out of here. Returning home.
There's a lot more supercharging to be done on that level if you want all the gems, obviously.
Well, unfortunately, I don't care much for worldly possessions in this game.
No, this is Amish Spyro.
Amish Spyro. As a dragon, I prefer my moderation, otherwise I'll grow big and greedy.
Okay, down through the cave. To the left.
To the left cave.
That cave, yes. Gonna have to charge.
Oh, yeah. That's right, you get super... That's supercharge.
Oh, look, they're blocking the entrance. How cute. Ow. And that's how Spyro got a concussion.
Oh, I imagine dragon bones are the hardest, like dragon scales. Like, people make armor out of them because it's, like, mythically hard.
Yeah. That also sounds like a good description for a Taru.
Mythically hard. I get it.
Fucking Sparta killed him.
Sparta killed him. Sparta does a lot of killing. You're talking about,
Wizard Peak.
Sparta Kick?
Yeah. You Sparta kicked him with fire.
God.
You Sparta shotgunned him off.
That's a very satisfying thing to see. Just this one dude just kicking somebody square in the chest. That's one of the best kicks ever.
Now you know why it's so fun with Ganondorf. You discovered how fun Zelda teleporting was today.
Oh, yeah. No, that's satisfying as hell. It's just... You teleport into somebody, and then they just go flying.
Well, this guy can summon yetis, I guess. Also, more water, don't you love it?
Give Raksha Shin Gong Wu. Give Raksha Shin Gong Wu.
I'd attempt the yodel, but I don't think I can pull it off.
Forgot he yodeled. I guess the yodeling is very, who does the yodeling? Is it the Dutch or the...
Voila. That's a good question.
Because if we can settle the yodeling question, then we can finally discover what origin that abominable snowman is.
I think it's all of them. Like, Germans, Dutch, and Swedish are known for yodeling.
Well, shit! We didn't solve anything!
And Lederhosen.
Let me get into my Lederhosen.
Well, at least you got rich dying.
Got get extra, rich or die trying!
Got an extra $5 on your deathbed.
We're gonna bury him with this $5. You know what? You know what I don't see in fantasy? Because dragons are always supposed to be, like, creatures that are, like, dangerous and shit. They hoard treasure. Why not have them dragons be, like, bankers?
Yeah.
Like, welcome to Dragon Bank.
Well, would you trust your money to a bank dragon? You'd never get it back.
You do have a good point there. Like,
they'd have to, like, it'd have to be a really trustworthy dragon who just, like, enjoys basking in your treasure, but he knows it's not forever.
Yeah. Maybe it's like for dragons. Oh, man. These things hurt.
Yeah, you're taking a lot of hits from these guys.
He retreated.
Yeah.
I guess, yeah, it's just a dragon. Maybe it's like the fact that, like, you know how many people store their shit at my bank? That's a form of hoarding.
Welcome to.
You're hoarding other people's money for safekeeping.
My favorite supercharge spot. Use it to bash those wizards.
I mean, logically, it would make sense for a dragon. Because it's money that the dragon otherwise would not be able to bask in.
Yes.
So they get to, you know, have a little more surrounding them.
Come closer. Bask in my treasure. Welcome to Dragon Safe Deposit Box. Don't
nothing
fuck with
safer.
Us. Nothing safer than entrusting your money to a dragon. I'd like to deposit my $1 million. $1 million, that's great.
Right this way, sir.
Yes, this is. I'll put this with the rest of the money in the money pot.
What if the Straw Hats had a dragon on their crew?
Like, it'd have to be a. Would it be a small dragon? It'd have to be a small dragon.
Yeah.
Like baby dragon. It wouldn't talk. It'd just be like.
It guards the treasure on Nami's behalf.
Oh.
Lives in Nami's
it would be
room.
Friends with Chopper.
Yeah. I want that to happen now, actually. That sounds pretty cool.
Yeah, dragon is a pet. I mean, we've established that they've established dragons exist in that universe.
Yeah. Well,
and are actually, they're pretty chill.
In non-canon, granted, but still in the anime.
Fuck it. I mean, everything else exists in that world. Technology.
Yeah.
Magic.
You want to get that dragon before you die?
Yeah. You know, I like the fact that people are willing.
Thank you for releasing me.
Good talk.
Thank you. People are willing to take like established creatures and just kind of fuck with them a little bit.
Yeah.
If people do like rigidly stick to something, then it's like
the lore never changes.
Well, it's like, oh, you know what to expect, and it's very, very just predictable.
Yeah.
Like, say what you will about the Twilight vampires.
At least they innovated.
Well, at least the author tried something new. Didn't just stick to the. Okay, first of all, these are they die in sunlight. They're weak to garlic. They're weak to silver.
Yeah.
Now, just going down the checklist, she's like, oh, vampires in this universe, they don't die when they go into sunlight. Granted, the alternative is kind of stupid, but you know, I've seen stupider. Oh, I've seen stupider. I've watched Sword for Truth.
Then there's Helsing, that which calls some of those tropes stupid and then follows others.
Well, I mean, it's like, you can follow some tropes if
yeah.
It's like, it's not like you have to like disregard all of them or none of them.
I wouldn't go for him. I don't think you're dexterous enough to make it around that platform with one hit.
Alas, I'm getting better at this though.
Now that you know you don't have to hold forward.
I'm not gonna go out of my way to get all the treasure, but I am just gonna grab the stuff that I see.
You're gonna hoard.
Yeah. I wish I had a treasure hoard. If I did, fuck.
Splat.
I went splat. If I did, I would be fucking perma broke.
Yeah.
Okay, if you ever got $1 million, what would be the first thing you'd spend some of it on?
A better place than this. I'm a humble guy.
Would you take me with you?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, thank you.
I'm a humble guy. I just want to be able to like do nothing.
Oh, so do I.
I don't need anything fancy.
I buy a two-story place. separate rooms, a nice big place for a recording studio.
And Chinese food every day.
Every day. And also all the weed I could smoke. And a place that would allow people to smoke weed.
Fuck it, we'd own.
We'd own a place. Yeah, that'd be-
Just get a house.
Yes.
Which would cost at least a quarter of our $1 million alone.
Well, it'd be a good investment.
Houses ain't cheap.
Gosh.
That's kind of crazy to think. You think $1 million is such a rich person amount.
It was in the 90s!
Listen carefully.
Hey, Lucas.
There's a secret area in the artisan home. It is at the waterfall. Try jumping on the stones there.
Wait, what?
Artisan home, waterfall. Sounds good.
That's how you get to the flight level in the first world.
Oh.
Which you don't care about. All the dragons. Wow, we're getting through this fast.
Yeah, this game is pretty...
If you don't go... It's one of those games that's really easy to finish and difficult to 100% because of all the gems are what's hidden obscurely.
Yeah.
Not the dragons. We're playing Babby mode. That's okay, we'll get through it.
Yeah, we'll get through it.
And then when it comes to the end, if, we make, oh no, I guess I don't have a save file on this. So otherwise, we could just load up my save file and do the thing you get for 100%.
Yeah. What other levels are left? We gotta get the boss.
Just the boss is the last one.
Alright, where's the boss? I'm...
Presumably the end of the... I think he's weather.
Fuck it!
All in! You gotta take the corners inside, man.
How do I get up there?
You can't. You just have to catch him before he reaches the end of the U. Ow. They sound like robots.
I kinda did it!
But why? I love you, master.
How about we toss around the pigskin?
Nope. He's too fast.
I just wanted my own body.
Oh, right. The dude bot.
Yeah.
I don't like feeling human.
I'm giving my robot its own emotions. What kind of tactical advantage would that have, Jack Spicer?
Despite the snowman weirdness, that was a good episode overall.
Well...
That was the same episode, remember? The robot.
Oh, yeah, that's right!
Let's you and I be friends.
Give Raksha Shin Gong Wu. That was also the episode in which they, like, that ghost chick Wuya just decided, no, fuck Jack Spicer. Despite the fact that she was eventually Jack Spicer's Iago at that point.
One of several times. She started out as the big evil threat where Jack Spicer was a sidekick, but
then
Jack quickly realized she couldn't do shit without a body.
Yeah, and he didn't need her to track down Shin Kong Wu because he invented a device.
So the 1500-year-old ancient evil witch was just a bit character next to Jack Spicer.
And eventually Chase Young. A guy is so evil, he's literally...
The most evil to ever evil.
Ironically. This is going nowhere.
Yeah.
I'm gonna just get to the final level. Ah,
I'm just gonna kill myself. This is going nowhere. You can kill that wizard down there.
I wanted to get that thing. There, I did it.
Yeah.
Okay, I guess the final boss is up here.
To the right.
Over here?
Yep, you got further in the level to go yet. Or further in the world.
I keep thinking the disc skips every time that happens.
Yeah. Don't want to go in there.
Crystal flight. So, okay, then I guess it's behind here?
No. Back out to the left.
Okay.
And then up to the left here is where it is.
Oh, I see what you mean. Alright. That's doable. Wait. Can't I just...
You could go along that lip, yes.
But come on. There we go.
Maybe it's down there.
Oh, crap! Wait, down here?
Yeah.
Okay. All I know what's going on. This is set to automatic, so the other stick is useless.
What do you mean? You don't, like, it doesn't have...
No, no camera control.
Oh, that's...
Okay. That's kind of weird. I'm going to switch it back.
No, it's not the camera control. That would have to be something with
the emulator. Is it L2 and R2 or camera?
Oh, you're right! Fuck! I'm so used to it being the other stick in other games.
Yeah, in modern games.
Yeah, because it makes sense in modern games!
Well, that's just what it was developed to. This was still developing technology. They hadn't figured out what made sense yet.
This makes me kind of... This kind of thing makes me hopeful that the HTC Vive / Oculus becomes successful.
Blow hard! You ready to get blown hard?
Oh.
Are you hard enough to get blown, son?
Oh, that's so fucking hot. Wait. Oh, there's no lava in this one.
Hello, person in chat.
I can't see your name because the screen's blocking it.
Yeah.
Good to have you join us. We're almost done with this, though.
Okay. One, two. All right, we got more gems.
All the hoarding. That's how Spyro grows big and strong.
You will never be as rich in real life as you will in this game, both in a physical and spiritual sense.
I don't know, gems seem pretty common in this world. Maybe they're actually worth just, like, pocket change.
I mean, in this world, sure, but in our world, fuck,
Can you imagine having, like, 1,000 gems?
I'd have to sell them all, like, to different places in order to maximize my profit.
Yeah.
Here, have this incredibly rare, valuable gem. I'll take it, good sir. Thank you, good sir. Go to another jewelry store. Hey, I got this incredibly rare, valuable gem. You want it? Sure, thank you, sir.
At least they've got the lore consistent. Like, when I was younger, I never was aware of the trope of dragons being hoarders. So, I mean, yeah. It makes sense that you're collecting gems in this game.
Yeah, well... Dragons weren't hoarders in, were they hoarders in the Slayer's verse?
No, not really.
They're just kind of assholes. Oh, is that a boss?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, I got him, finally.
And then he fucked off. But too many of the bosses in this game are just hit them and they run away to the next arena.
They're all cowards. It's like most of the bosses behave realistically when fighting a dragon. Oh no, a dragon!
Oh
shit!
Oh no, water. My one weakness.
It's like most of the bosses are like, oh fuck, a dragon, and then they fuck off. They fuck off faster than that Greyjoy did it with John Wick.
If they're afraid of this kind of dragon, can you imagine what would happen if they like ran into Shendu or something?
Oh. They surrender on the spot. Shan! Is he a hoarder?
I mean, he hoarded talismans, but those were kind of his to begin with, so...
He like, created the talismans.
Then again, he was technically a demon who looked like a dragon, not so... I don't know.
Like, literal... No, he was a dragon! And you'll find out why in Season 3 that he's a dragon.
Okay.
We'll get to that.
Shendu, officially a dragon. You heard it here, folks. Oh,
run! Oh, no!
Good recovery, though. Remember, triangle drops you out of the glide.
Yeah, triangle drops me out of the glide. Because why not just do I even need to glide?
Yeah.
No, I don't. Ah!
Panic!
Ah! Shit!
One hit left.
I can beat a boss, but I can't beat physics.
The difficulty isn't in fighting him, it's in getting to him. Like, if this guy were smart, he would just keep the platform up, and then Spyro would never progress.
Yeah, if he was smart, but unfortunately...
Bad guys in video games are never smart.
Shame about that. What's over here? Ah! No! No!
Spyro for Smash 5. I wish he was still that relevant.
Wait, is Skylanders a Nintendo thing, or is it just kind of a whatever console take us thing?
I don't think it's on Wii U, no.
Oh, well.
Otherwise, it's like a direct competitor to Amiibos, so.
Oh, and I guess
Disney Xfinity.
Yeah. Why is everybody doing that? That is the weirdest fucking trend in gaming right now.
Disney Infinity, yeah. Like, electronic action... Well, not even action figure.
Just collect... We're gonna find collectibles and we're gonna make them useful.
That's that was a thing in the past, too. Just not... It didn't take off until now.
Yeah.
I guess it was just the technology.
Perhaps. There we go. Slowdown helped.
Yeah, it is still doing some stuttering. Not as bad as Banjo, which was really low frames per second.
Banjo was borderline unplayable.
Yeah.
Alright,
Altair!
Thanks for releasing me, Spyro. You have no idea how long I've been trapped in Crystal. And, neither do I. Who are you again?
I'm out of here.
At least he had more to say than thanks for releasing me.
Yeah, no, it's like, thanks for releasing me, now let's get uncomfortable for a little bit.
Old people are funny.
The music's still really loud.
Yeah?
It's just, again, comparison to everything else.
What was it? I think it was Spyro 2 introduced skill points, which, as you know, became features in the Ratchet & Clank games and onward.
Yeah. Yeah, and of course, Insomniac were the ones that did Ratchet & Clank.
Yes.
With Naughty Dog doing,
Crash, and then Jack and Daxter.
And then after Uncharted. Jack and Daxter, they did, who did Uncharted? Was it them?
I'm pretty sure
I think it was
them.
Naughty Dog.
Yeah, and, Sucker Punch did Infamous.
Yeah.
In addition to Sly Cooper. That goes nowhere.
Who did... So, I think one of those three companies you're describing also did Sunset Overdrive.
That was also Insomniac, so yeah. These guys. So, yeah, of course the Ratchet & Clank guys did Sunset Overdrive.
Oh, no!
I slipped! You've bested me this time, Blowhard! You and your accursed wind powers.
He knows the terrain. He's fighting a terrain that's advantageous to him.
Don't dragons have claws? You'd think they could, like, scale the walls or something. I don't know.
This is a baby dragon, though.
Yeah. Spyro 2 also introduces a lot more characters, so...
More than the 40-something dragons we got here?
Well, I mean, the only relevant characters are Spyro and Sparks.
Yeah, so. You're right about that. I'm just saying.
There's a lot more personality to the second game as well. Wrong way again. Watch that first step, it's a doozy.
It's a dilly!
Did he just fuck off? You didn't fight him! You didn't even have to, he just left a gem and ran.
I guess they assumed that you beat him before?
He's just afraid of you.
Oh fuck, a dragon! Better fuck off!
I hope the levels on this are okay. You're right, it is getting loud, but I didn't notice until just this level. Was it just this level that was this loud?
The boss levels are always way louder than every other fucking level.
I guess we beat him! Okay!
He left! He's like, no, I'm not dealing with the dragon!
They don't pay me enough. I've never seen that happen before. I guess because you got the dragon statue? I don't know.
Well, best not to look a gift dragon in the mouth.
There was a glitch in some game. I think it was one of the Halo games that you could, like the final boss had a chance of glitching and like tripping off a cliff and that would instantly end the fight. And I think I heard of it.
On Halo?
Halo or Gears of War or some game.
Gears of War sounds more likely because Halo wasn't too big on boss battles. There's like two. There's like one in the first game and that was in a ship, so that doesn't count.
And I heard that happening to someone playing the game, and they thought that was just like how the game ended. Like, there was no final boss, and it was just cheaped out like that. For the longest time, Tuco.
Those Tuco. Sneaky
thieves. Okay, five dragons.
Are you serious?
How many have we... Is that five total? Or stay... I guess stay here. Count your dragon eggs.
Maybe, I got three.
Maybe we got four.
So I can...
three.
I can...
For this world or in total?
Total.
Check the other worlds. Left and right on the D-pad.
We got one here.
Okay, so got... yeah, we need two more.
Fucking hell. Oh my god. Okay. Alright, fine. I'll fetch you your fucking dragon eggs, asshole.
There are two in the homeworld. Do you want me to get them so it's faster?
I know which ones you're talking about.
Yeah, there are two just right out here.
Yeah, fuck it. Get them.
Okay. Back to me. Well, I mean, to me for the first time.
Something we gotta do a game that we both have no idea how to play.
Well, that's gonna be that's gonna be Conquer.
Just do a good old fashioned blind run of something.
Conquer will be that.
Oh, neither of us have played Conquer, huh?
Nope.
I guess now that Banjo-Kazooie's out of the question, we could just start on Conquer.
Yeah, that can come soon. Probably after Mario, maybe? It is running really slow now.
You got one. It's fine. It's running way better than Banjo-Kazooie did.
Yeah.
Which had a tendency to stop every time it was in a bad mood, which was constantly.
I can see why you'd be having difficulties, though.
Why?
With this, like, laggy kind of thing.
Yeah.
Get over here, you fucker!
Does this just kinda reset? I guess it does?
Maybe? Hopefully. There he is.
Just fire at him.
Damn it!
You know, if you could... when I suggested that, I assumed you could aim.
Yeah.
What am I complaining? You're still doing better than I did.
Oh, I didn't even need to.
Good. Okay, now we can leave.
See, that dragon eggs are significant. There, for one thing.
Can you recover five dragon eggs? Why?
Oh, you know, just cause.
I need to be kind to the dragons. Spyro's like, something's fishy about that Tuco dude. He sounds like a guy who would be in a show called Breaking Bad.
They look like black mages. They're faceless, these guys.
Tuco, you sound like you sell crystal meth, dude. I shouldn't trust...
Great work, Spyro. You must be faster than you look. The Beastmaker's world.
What?
Are we gonna find a bunch of dragon Pokemon trainers?
Beastmakers?
Back to Jack.
As in they... Well, for like...
Until you just gotta get one dragon and save is all.
Yeah. Beastmakers.
And we're just under an hour.
That is Zelos's world.
I guess that was his demon boss was the Beast Master.
Yeah, I heard of that.
What's her name?
Beast Master.
The Swamp Level.
Metallum? Metallum?
I don't remember.
Megalum? I don't know. I've heard the name once.
Ready for technology?
Ah!
And electricity.
Wait, the world called the Beastmaker's World's main thing is that it has is cyberpunk?
Well, maybe they're, like, corrupting it. I mean, obviously, this is, like, a swamp setting.
Okay. How many dragons are here? Just two.
So you're gonna have to find one of them.
Sounds like it's easier said than done! Hey, guy, you wanna go?
The best part of a platformer is waiting. Charge!
Ah, fuck! Just short. Okay, it's loud here too.
Oh, there's one.
Okay, cool.
Almost walked right by it. Bruno.
Yeah.
Master Nork is turning our swamp into an electrified junk heap. And it used to be so beautiful.
I'm sure it was.
Mm-hmm.
Of course they're in a swamp, so he has a Louisiana accent.
You know, there are other swamps besides the Louisiana one. There's a Florida swamp.
Why can't I leave my beautiful swamp alone?
I guess Scotland has a bunch of swamps, yeah. What? Okay. Fucking.
You're gonna ask why Shrek was Scottish?
I mean, it was kinda inexplicable, yeah.
I guess. It gave him character, though.
Alright, are we done?
Yeah, we're done. Okay. Drown out the loud
music. I might be on later tonight, and if I am, check out my channel.
Yeah, go see S.A. Jack Anderson if he starts streaming.
Yep. Anyway. Right.
Thank you for watching,
guys. Thank you for watching. We'll see you later.
See you later, guys.
Good night.